Right, we saw Wes Borland answering back his former boss, Fred Someone.
Some of what Limp Bizkit was, I liked, but the stuff that I didn't like, that, you know, about the music was so much that it was like, you know, I couldn't listen to those songs, I couldn't listen to our records, and, you know, I couldn't really be proud of what I was doing and stand completely behind it.
Now, though, Wes has a proper new band he can express himself in without feeling he has to suck the corporate fleshy parts. It's called Eats the Day, and here he is to tell us all about it.
I'm the same guitar player that I was in Limp Bizkit. If you liked the Limp Bizkit guitar stuff, it is, you know, I'm still using the same guitars. We're trying to not have a front man type of thing. My brother and I we've always wanted to sing and always wrote lyrics, so we've been doing vocal lessons twice a week for the last 4 months because, you know, we're not singers. And we've been instrumental musicians for so long that I knew it was going to take a lot of kind of schooling. On this keyboard workstation over here, I named a file Eat the Day that just, like, real quickly, like was programming something and then was just like, Eat the Day, that's what that's called. And my brother was like, when we were thinking of names, he was like, what about Eat the Day, that file name? And I was like, okay, you know, that kind of works. And it's not intentionally like a seize the day type of thing, but it kind of worked in with the whole, like, me taking control of my life. Big Dumb Face definitely got all the comedy out of my system. He's a son of man. It's hard for people to understand that this same group of people that did the absurdity that was in Big Dumb Face is, you know, is going to produce a record that is not like. I guess part of me wanted to see how much I could get away with as far as, like, okay, I'm in this big rock band, let me put out a record of complete garbage to see what people do and how hard I get bashed and how many people kind of become a little cult following to it, because I think the music is, it was really easy to make and it's not hard to play. It's just sort of idiocy. It's not like a compilation of my personality, or our personalities. It was more like, if you ever have been drunk or done a drug and had an idea while you were under the influence that you thought would be good then, but then you sober up later and you go, oh, that wasn't such a good idea. It's holding on to that idea and going, I'm gonna see this all the way through.